DJI is the newest legit player in the portable power game. While they're a drone company, they're also known for being perfectionists that make sure they really dial everything in before they release it. But who is DJI? Why are they making power stations? And didn't we just learn that two of their former employees started EcoFlow? Welcome back to the Solar Lab. Today we're going to learn how a dorm room dream turned into a multi-billion dollar drone empire. And more importantly, what this could mean for the portable power industry. So let's pull back the curtain and take a look behind the brand. It all started back in 2006 with young visionary Frank Wang. Wang's fascination with flight led him to the Hong Kong University of Science and Technology, where he pursued his passion for aerial robotics. After excelling in the program and winning a bunch of competitions, he decided to found a company right out of his dorm room. The company was DJI, short for Da Jiang Innovations, or something like Great Frontier Innovations in English. From the very beginning, the vision was clear: make advanced drone technology accessible for enthusiasts and professionals alike. Wang sold his first prototypes and was able to use those funds to found a small office and staff in Shenzhen, China. DJI's initial focus was on creating flight control systems for drones. The first big release was the E310, a drone propulsion system, which is basically just a motor for a drone. That quickly gained the company a lot of attention. But in 2013, they launched their first mega hit, the Phantom series. Now these drones really put the brand on the map. The Phantom series were entry-level drones that were known for being way more user-friendly than anything else out there at the time. Now DJI really leaned into this beginner-friendly angle. They made them easier to fly, harder to crash, and even protected the propellers with bumper systems. Now at this point, drones are a pretty niche thing, and the Phantom series was so beginner-friendly that regular people started looking at them as a viable thing. So you start having YouTubers, hobbyists start picking them up. And as everyone knows, once YouTubers get their hands on something, the general public also wants it. In 2015, the Phantom 3 took things to an even higher level thanks to its integrated live streaming camera. This made aerial photography and videography more accessible than ever before. By this point, the Phantom series is becoming so popular that DJI is actually the biggest consumer drone company on the planet. Now, this is also about the same time that they got into funding competitive robot fighting, which is as cool or as lame as you think it sounds. So by now, DJI is a very serious player in the drone market. At the same time, drone technology is becoming way more mainstream. You're starting to see wedding photographers, YouTubers, real estate agents, search and rescue teams, all starting to adopt drone technology. So drones are becoming way more popular, and DJI is the only company that's making them cheaper. Basically a recipe for success. During this dominant period, they also began to expand their product line. The Modular Inspire series catered to professionals, while 2016's Mavic series offered portability and high performance, making them appealing for general use. DJI also started to follow a little bit of a pattern with their products. They'd release a product, improve it. Release a product, improve it. Always making sure that the latest drones improved on the design of the previous generation. They also started to really lean into accessories for their drones, allowing their customers to customize and upgrade their setup. If you remember from our last Behind the Brand, this is also around the same time that the founders of EcoFlow left DJI to start their own company. As an interesting note, all of those founders worked in DJI's battery department. This actually makes a lot of sense when you consider that the original EcoFlow products were basically just crowdfunded battery banks. Now, we could go on and make a 3-hour documentary on DJI, their products, and the huge impact they had on the drone industry, but we're a solar channel, not drone guys. The main takeaway is that DJI remained a dominant player in the drone market. They're just a huge company with a really solid reputation. But despite DJI's success, they also faced challenges, particularly in the United States. Concerns over national security led to efforts to restrict and regulate the use of Chinese-made drones. This controversy has only ramped up with how we've seen drones used in the war in Ukraine, especially given both sides of the war have been using DJI products for surveillance and even carrying explosives. Back in the United States, the opposition to these bans argued that banning Chinese-made drones would disrupt essential services that depended on drone and DJI technology. Plus, domestic alternatives were seen as not as advanced and a lot more expensive. Lucky for DJI, the bans didn't pass and their drones are still available in the United States. But it's still something that lingers over the company's head. Now, we're not trying to get political, but when a company starts facing potential bans for their products, they really have to look at expanding their horizons. Now, this might explain why DJI has since started to expand their product line, which now includes GoPro-style action cameras, podcasting microphones, e-bike parts, combat robots, and of course, power stations. DJI ventured into the world of portable power in April of last year. They started with the high-capacity Power 1000. It's a versatile, entry-size power system that was designed with their existing customers in mind. It's ridiculously quiet, so you can bring it inside a studio and not have to worry about it messing up your audio. It also has SDC ports for fast charging drones and other DJI accessories. It's pretty much the perfect unit for creatives, but it can also be used for camping and basic home backup. When we tested it, it was powerful, it was quiet, it worked really well, and basically was just everything you'd want out of a basic power station. They also released the more affordable 500. Pretty much the same thing, just a little bit smaller. You get a much more entry-level price point, but it's still powerful enough to charge camera batteries, drones, and other basic electronics. Just like their drones, their power stations have been sleek, work really well, and it's just super obvious that DJI put a lot of effort into the design. We've reviewed some absolute junk on this channel, so for a company to come in and absolutely smash it with their first two releases, it's really impressive. Since dropping these first two power stations, it seems like DJI's seen some real potential in the market because they haven't slowed down at all. They've kicked off 2025 doing what DJI does best, releasing a bunch of accessories. The fastest car charger on the market, car and solar charger combos, hand trucks so you can carry them around easier, expansion batteries, a Wi-Fi dongle because the original units didn't support Wi-Fi, tons of cables and extras, carrying cases. Pretty much anything they've heard people say they wanted, they've since released it. So kudos to DJI for that. Most brands release a product and then totally walk away, where DJI seems willing to put the R&D into releasing upgrades that'll work with their existing power stations. We like this because you can just go out and buy some cheap accessories to upgrade what you already own instead of having to drop thousands of dollars on a totally new power station. Speaking of which, they did just drop a totally new power station, the Power 2000. As you can probably guess from the name, it's got a bigger battery, bigger inverter, and it even has a 30 amp plug. This shows us that DJI is trying to expand beyond the creative market. They've already released a hand truck for it, which shows that they're starting to cater to people that want bigger systems. What surprised us the most about the 2000 is how lightweight and small it is for a power station with its specs. Again, this shows that they're putting some R&D into creating products that actually look good and aren't just exact clones of everything else that's on the market. It also shows us that DJI isn't messing around and they obviously want to become big players in this industry. And if some of the rumors are true about the things they're working on, they might just be after EcoFlow's launch. Either way, it's a really good thing to have a company that has a good reputation for affordability and quality enter the power station market. But that's where DJI is currently at, and we're really excited to see where they take things. If you want to learn more about their power stations, check out the channel. We've been really impressed with DJI so far, but what do you guys think? Do you think DJI can take over the portable power station game? And what do you think of their products so far? And let us know if there's other brands you want us to take a look at. But that's it for now. Thanks for watching. Peace out and stay charged.